Hi, I'm Brittany with Tennis Warehouse here at the BNP Paribas Open in the Head Stringing Room. Now I'm here with Head's Roger Petersman, and we're going to talk today about restringing. Now there's a lot of myths when it comes to restringing. There's a myth that you only restring your racket when the string breaks. There's a myth that you restring it depending on how often you play. Now we're going to talk a little bit about how often you really should be restringing, whether you're a competitive junior or college player versus an average rec player or league player.
Well, a college or competitive junior are going to be stringing before every match. I mean, they really need the high performance of that string, and they need it performing and the resilience that they're going to get out of that string bed every single time. So they're going to probably restring every match. But the average club player, as long as they take care of their racket and don't leave it in your car, take it in wherever you go, because the heat or cold will actually kill your string bed. But if they're doing that, they should be able to get, you know, 2 or 3 months out of it, depending. Don't wait for it to break. That's the worst thing you can do, because you'll lose all the resilience in about 2 to 3 months anyway. So you're going to be getting nothing out of that racket. One, the extra vibrations can cause tennis elbow, and you're just going to be having those balls fly. You'll adjust your stroke, which will actually make your game a little lower, and you won't play as well. So by restringing, you're going to keep the resilience of that string bed up. You're going to be getting more power and more control out of it, and that's really what you want. So I say about every 2 or 3 months for the average club player, you want to restring your rackets.
So now, if the players are stringing with polyester string, how long would you say on average that playability is up there before it starts to drop off?
It's going to start to drop off pretty quick. I mean, polys start losing tension immediately when they come off of the string stringing machine. So really, a month for your average club player. These guys are restringing 3-4 rackets a match, because the tension does drop and they want to keep it up there as tight as they can, keep that resilience there. But your average player is probably going to get about a month out of it. If you really want to use a poly, I recommend using a hybrid. Hybrid with something that's got a little bit more resilience to it. An average club player is not going to get the benefit of poly, because poly really allows you to swing as hard as you want and control the ball. And most of your club players aren't really stringing that hard, or swinging that hard. So if they hybrid it with some sort of a multi-filament or something a little softer, it's going to extend the life of that string a little bit longer, and they still will get some benefit.
Now let's talk a little bit about tension. What are the tension ranges you're seeing here at the BNP?
It's funny, because these pros are all over the place. Some of them are as low as 40 pounds, and some of them are as tight as 80. So it's really a wide range depending upon their game. I mean, most of the time, if you look at the average club player, if you look at the recommended range on a racket and you stay in the middle there, that's going to give you the optimum performance for that frame. And a lot of these manufacturers, especially like Head and some of the other ones, we do a lot of testing on where exactly that recommended tension should be, so that you're going to get the most out of your racket string bed combination. So I would try to stay in there. If you like it a little bit more control, go a little tighter. If you want a little bit more power, go a little looser, but try to stay in that range.
Now, you've been here at the BNP for the last couple days, and it's been super busy. You were also here for the Oracle Challenger before. How many rackets have you been restringing up to this date?
It's funny, the Oracle Challenger, they came in, they kind of gave us an average of what they were doing. We blew those numbers away. We had a lot of players come in early, a lot of top players played this Challenger, which you don't always get depending upon where it's located and what the tournaments are. But because Indian Wells is right afterwards, they all came in early. We did over 650 rackets just for the Challenger. And they're already over 2,000 rackets for this tournament so far. I think their biggest day was 318 frames. So kind of wish we would have brought a couple stringers in earlier, but it's worked out pretty well, and we're keeping up with it, so it's good.
Well, thank you so much for joining us, Roger. For more information on any Head strings, please check it out at tenniswarehouse.com.